Hi everyone, my name is Megan. I'm the education intern at the Smithsonian Marine Ecosystems exhibit at the St. Lucie County Aquarium. And I'm gonna be sharing with you today a short little activity that you can do at home. So this activity today is called the Great Plankton Sink-Off. This activity helps to teach about plankton and how they stay afloat in the water. So plankton are tiny plants and animals that cannot move against a current. Plants and animals have to figure out a way to stay afloat. And they do this in a variety of ways. They'll either add spikes or be nice and flat to increase their surface area, or they'll produce extra fats and oils so they stay nice and buoyant in the water. Your goal today is going to be to create your own plankton and see how slow you can get your plankton to sink. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the materials you're going to need and show you how I would make my plankton. So the great thing about this activity is that there are only two materials that you need in order to make it work. The first thing that you're going to need is some sort of modeling clay or Play-Doh, something like this. And you're going to want to break it into about quarter size in diameter, or maybe about the size of a cherry tomato. This is going to be the clay that you use to build your plankton. And then you need something to test your plankton in. So I'm gonna use this old storage bin. I'm gonna fill it up with water and drop my plankton in to test it. You can use whatever you have around the house, a bucket, a storage bin like this, or even just sort of like a tall vase that you may have. For the other stuff to build your plankton, you can use any craft supplies that you may have. So around my house, I had some pipe cleaners. I had some of these bamboo skewers. I had some nice buttons, little popsicle sticks, some foam, and then some clothespins as well. So there are a couple of rules when it comes to making a plankton. First thing, you have to use all of the clay that you are given. Make sure everyone is starting off on an even foot. And the second thing is that you want your plankton to actually sink in the water. You don't want it to float, because if it floats in real life, it wouldn't survive in the ocean. So I've made a few different designs based on some of the plankton adaptations that I know about. I did one design that's nice and flat. It increases the surface area of my plankton, so hopefully it'll sink a little slower. I have this one here with some spikes on it. These spikes will also help increase the surface area, so hopefully this guy will sink nice and slow. This one, I broke up the clay a little bit. I spread it out so it's a little more evenly distributed, and hopefully that'll help it not sink as fast. And with this one, I added this foam on the top and the bottom, and this reminded me of maybe some extra oil a plankton might produce to help it stay nice and buoyant, nice and floating in the water. So after you have designed your plankton, you can go ahead and test them out. But before you test them, I want to see a picture of your plankton that you made, so share a picture with us, tag us on Instagram or on Twitter, so we can see your plankton designs and you can share your creations with the world. So I've got my big bin of water here and I'm going to show you how to test your plankton. You're going to need a timer. I'm going to use my watch right here, and you're going to take your plankton. I think I'm going to start with this nice flat one, and you're going to count down. You go 1, 2, 3. Drop it in, start the timer, and then when it hits the bottom, you want to stop the timer, okay? So that one sank pretty fast. This plankton design right here, this didn't work because it's just floating on top of the water. You want to make sure that your plankton is going to sink. So this one, unfortunately, is disqualified. So after you've tested your plankton, you can go ahead and make any changes you want to your design. Maybe add some stuff. For this one, I'd probably take some stuff away since it just floated, and then you can test your design again. And you can keep going and going until you find your perfect plankton. I want to thank you all so much for joining me today. I hope you enjoy this activity, and don't forget to share a picture of your creation with us either at Twitter or Instagram. Thank you so much. Have a great day.